Frozen IVF embryos are legally considered children. That is what the Alabama Supreme Court just ruled in a landmark first-of-its-kind decision. And this could have huge, sweeping implications, not just for the residents of the state, but for hundreds of thousands of Americans across the country who desperately want to start a family and rely on these treatments. Because an important thing to know is that this ruling stems from wrongful death lawsuits, with them alleging that a patient broke into a fertility clinic and accidentally dropped other couples' frozen embryos, destroying them. And as a part of those challenges, the plaintiffs claimed that the clinic had violated Alabama's Wrongful Death of a Minor Act. But there, a circuit court judge struck that down, ruling that a frozen embryo isn't considered a minor child under the law because it hadn't been transferred to the uterus, and arguing that the state Supreme Court and the state legislature had a clear pattern of using that qualification specifically to define unborn or minor children. But the state Supreme Court then said, cool story, no, with them ruling that the 1872 Wrongful Death of a Minor Act and the state's constitution don't draw that distinction, and actually saying that embryos have the same protections as all other children under the law, plus adding that this is especially true in places like Alabama, where voters adopted a constitutional amendment directly aimed at stopping courts from excluding unborn life from legal protection. With that, seemingly in reference to a 2018 ballot measure that gave fetuses full personhood rights. So notably, that amendment did not mention frozen embryos. But regardless, the majority of justices here argued that they had a duty to protect unborn life without exception, with them frequently citing the Alabama Constitution and Christian faith. Right, God is mentioned numerous times in the ruling, especially with Chief Justice Tom Parker, who drew heavily from the Bible in a concurring opinion that reads like a straight-up sermon from a pastor. With all that, him arguing that the people of Alabama have adopted a theologically based view of the sanctity of life, and adding, human life cannot be wrongfully destroyed without incurring the wrath of a holy God who views the destruction of his image as an affront to himself. Even before birth, all human beings bear the image of God, and their lives cannot be destroyed without effacing his glory. Which again, very big thing here, this is not his personal comments, this is his legal opinion. And that opinion has drawn a lot of criticism from reproductive rights advocates who say that his personal religious beliefs could be influencing his decision, and saying that is especially concerning because the decision could have a massive impact. Right, the ruling here is exceptionally vague on a number of fronts, and so there are a ton of concerns about what this means in practice, and particularly when it comes to the storage of embryos. Or when someone undergoes IVF, there are multiple embryos that are made, but not all are used, with the unused ones kept frozen in storage. But now you have the Alabama Supreme Court saying those embryos are in fact people with the same rights and protections as children. And so there are major concerns about what happens to those frozen embryos. So with that, some outlets explaining, this ruling raises questions about what happens to those unused embryos in storage, whether authorities could order them to be implanted in unwilling parents or bring child abuse charges. And what happens if a doctor implants embryos that fail to develop? So you have experts saying a number of things, saying this ruling could make IVF way more expensive, or just force fertility clinics to shut down and doctors to leave the state entirely, or because they could actually be held liable for homicide charges just for getting rid of extra embryos. And that's even with the approval of the couple who made it. And the same could be true if there's an accident that damages an embryo and potentially even miscarriages. Because there are a ton of different possibilities here. We're talking about a state that already accounts for almost half of all pregnancy-related criminal cases across the entire country. And again, this could extend beyond Alabama and, in particular, the 11 states that define personhood as beginning at fertilization. With Dana Sussman, the Deputy Executive Director of Pregnancy Justice, explaining, this is a natural extension of the march toward fetal personhood. You only need one state to be the first out of the gate, and then the next one will feel less radical. This is a cause of great concern for anyone that cares about people's reproductive rights and abortion care. And I mean, the impact here could be very, very far-reaching, because according to the CDC, nearly 100,000 babies are born via IVF every year. And it's been estimated that right now there are between 600,000 to 1 million embryos in storage nationwide. And get this, there are estimates saying that about 21% of them are abandoned. And so in addition to all those other concerns, if you're in a state affected like this, which right now is Alabama, if you own one of those clinics, what do you do? Like, even though they have a contract saying they can destroy them, do they not? Because that would be considered homicide. And also, if we're considering the embryos people or children, are there people out there that you could charge with abandoning a child? And I mean, it all just seems like a crazy, stupid mess. That is kind of the state of things. So while we see what the hell this is going to look like moving forward, of course, I'd love to know your thoughts in those comments down below.